New numbers on cross-border shopping are out there. Loblaws is launching a pilot project in discount groceries. Quebec retailer Simons is going after Sears. But our next guest has all the latest on these retail business stories. Ashleigh Patterson, Senior Finance Editor at Yahoo Canada. Ashleigh, great to see you.
Great to see you, too.
Okay, let's start with cross-border shopping, because there's a lot happening cross-border. Not only are we going there, and they're coming back, and they're coming here, because Target's coming here, Nordstrom's coming here.
Absolutely. What we found with the new StatsCan numbers that were out is that same-day travel to the U.S. from Canada has dropped. Significant number, 6% between March and April, and that is after 4 months of a consecutive rise, which really was spurred by the Canadian government loosening up duty-free limits for Canadian shoppers. But now we're seeing the opposite, which is kind of counterintuitive. When you think the weather gets nicer, people should be making more trips across the border, but they're really choosing to stay here. And like you said, it's because a lot of these, you know, big-name retailers, Target, Ann Taylor, J. Crew, they're on this side of the border now, so why make the trip?
Good point. Mm-hmm. And Nordstrom coming in 2014, too. Right?
Absolutely. Nordstrom is going to be opening between 8 and 10 stores in Canada. They're going to be starting out in Toronto, Ottawa, Vancouver, Calgary. And then they're also going to be opening up at least 20 of their off-the-rack concept stores. And really what those stores have is retail for 30 to 70% less. Nordstrom is really looking to take a piece of that kind of high-end pie. And they're going to be putting a lot of pressure on retailers that are already here, like Holt Renfrew.
Mm-hmm. I happened to be in Calgary over the weekend, and I think I drove by this new store format, I guess, they've got in Calgary from Loblaws.
Right, and grocery sector is definitely hot right now. We know that last week it was announced that Sobeys is going to be paying over $5 billion for Safeway Canada's assets here, and now it looks like Loblaws is going to be experimenting as well. And we've seen really over the past 10 years that Loblaws has really expanded into the suburbs. You know, the typical big box store that you see as soon as you get out of city limits, but it looks now like that market is a bit saturated and they're moving into urban centers. So they're trying out this pilot project in Calgary where they're going to be opening up small discount retailer. It's going to be called The Box by No Frills, and it's really going to be targeting that urban consumer dollar.
Yeah, that's exactly the story I saw. And what's this about Quebec store buying Sears?
Right, so Quebec-based Simons, which is a very popular retailer in that province, is potentially going to be moving west and potentially going to be moving to Toronto. So we know that Sears has essentially sold back leases of two of their popular stores to the mall owners. It was $191 million cash. And so now these two really popular retail spaces are open. One is at Yorkdale. And Simons looks like it might be taking a piece of the pie, but it's going to have, you know, a fight on its hands potentially, because Holt Renfrew is looking at expanding as well. So, I mean, I would like to personally see Simons in Toronto. I think it's a great retailer and something that could really shake it up.
What do you like about Simons?
I think that their clothing is fantastic. They have really trendy, cool stuff at a really good price point. So if we could see more of that competition coming into Toronto, I think that's only a good thing for consumers.
Yeah. Although I haven't seen prices going down that much.
No, still not. I mean, and we still have the classic, you know, typical Canadian-American price gap where we're paying at least 10 to 15% more than our neighbors in the U.S.
Why does that happen?
That's a good question. A lot of that has to do with tariffs. A lot of it has to do with taxes, essentially, that are slapped on products as they come over the border. But again, now as we see more U.S. retailers in the state, or sorry, coming to Canada, if you were going to spend that money on gas, hotel, to go over to the U.S. to purchase those products, it really kind of makes more sense to stay here at home now. I mean, if you're going to be spending that money for a 10% discount, does that really make sense? Especially when we know gas prices are on the rise, the loonie is under par, so it really makes more sense for consumers to stay here.
Never really understood that, though, because we're supposed to have a free trade agreement with the United States.
So. Right.
Oh, well. Ashleigh, great to have you here.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Ashleigh Patterson, Senior Finance Editor at Yahoo Canada, who joins us every week.